How do you get all of that energy your body needs? Your digestive system breaks down all that food you eat. Here's a quick tutorial of how your organs do work together, breaking down food to fuel your body, making it run better. It starts with your teeth grinding up all your food. This is called mastication. In this video, it's true. The tongue makes a saliva produced from salivary glands, making food much softer to move on with its digestive plan. When you swallow your food after it's been chewed, it passes the epiglottis, which covers the trachea in you. Then the upper esophageal sphincter will stay closed until the brain tells it to open to let your food go. When your food's in your esophagus, peristalsis occurs. That's when your circular and longitudinal muscles will work. These two muscles contract in a wave motion shown, pushing your food towards your stomach's main digestive zone. Peristalsis brings the food to your stomach's top, where your lower esophageal sphincter lets food drop. Once the food is in your stomach, the lower sphincter closes tight in order to keep your stomach acid out of sight. The stomach's hydrochloric acid and digestive enzymes are in charge of breaking down the food that you eat, turning it to chyme. This chyme is passed through your pyloric sphincter in you and me, in the duodenum, the first part of the small intestines 3. The duodenum mixes the digestive juices from your liver, pancreas, and gallbladder, then on it will run, preparing your chyme to be passed to your jejunum. This is where your small intestine starts the absorption. Your jejunum's your second segment. I hope you're not bored. That's where most of your food's nutrients will be absorbed. After your jejunum gets all the nutrients it needs, the chyme is passed to the ileum, which concludes my parts of 3. The ileum absorbs the remaining nutrients before beginning the journey into your large intestine. The large intestine's biggest job is absorbing water from your chyme. If it didn't perform this function, you'd have loose stools all the time. The large intestine has millions of bacteria that do work. E. coli is an important one. Here's its important perks. E. coli breaks down all the chyme that your body can't digest and produces vitamin K that regulates blood clotting at best. Then the large intestine has another important part to play. It excretes all your waste to help your body stay healthy.
How do you get all of that energy your body needs? Your digestive system breaks down all that food you eat. Here's a quick tutorial of how your organs do work together, breaking down food to fuel your body, making it run better. We're your teeth, we're your teeth, your digestive system star. We hope you listen well and you learn just who we are.
When you're a newborn baby, you may have natal teeth. This only occurs in 1 in 2 to 3,000 babies. A child's mouth has 2 rows of teeth on the bottom and the top, but you only see 20 before the adult teeth make the swap. You'll have 32 adult teeth by the young age of 13, but there are only 28 without your wisdom teeth, you see. Teeth are part of the skeletal system, though they are not bone. We play a key role in digestion to chew foods while we're grown.
We're your teeth, we're your teeth, your digestive system star. We hope you listen well and you learn just who we are.
You only have 4 different types of teeth in your whole mouth. Here's their names from front to back and from north down to the south. Incisors are like scissors cause they cut your food in half. They're in front of your mouth, you see all 8 when you laugh. Then we see your canines, there are only 4, you know. 2 are at the top and 2 more are in the jaw down below. Premolars are the next teeth that we will be looking at. There are 8 in total to help you start to chew all that fat. Molars are your biggest teeth and the last to chew your food. There are 12 inside your mouth, this fact is very true.
We're your teeth, we're your teeth, your digestive system star. We hope you listen well and you learn just who we are.
The anatomy of your teeth shown in this here photograph. First we'll look at the crown, the tooth's visible top half. Enamel is the outer part of all the teeth in your mouth.
It's the hardest part of your body, but if not brushed, it'll rot out. Here you see the dentin below the enamel closure. It's the hard, dense, bony tissue that protects your pulp chamber. Yeah, your pulp chamber houses the important root canal. Inside the root canal are the nerves and vessels' main locale. If all these top layers of your teeth do decay, the infection could be fatal, so please brush twice a day.
Wear your teeth, wear your teeth, your digestive system star. We hope you listen well and you learn just who we are. Wear your teeth, wear your teeth, your digestive system star. We hope you listen well and you learn just who we are.
What's that taste? Well, it's your tongue, a muscular organ in everyone. I'm kind of rough with lots of bumps. I always work hard to get my job done. Your tongue is covered in a pink tissue called mucosa. Its main job is to protect deeper tissue when you gnaw. The rough parts of your tongue are called the lingual papillae. They are the small bumps that store taste buds so you enjoy food all day. There are four different types of your tongue's papillae. They're named the filiform, foliate, fungiform, and circumvallate. The frenum is the tether of the front bottom of tongues. It holds your tongue in place so your mouth can move freely while it runs. The back of your tongue is anchored by the hyoid bone. The tongue is vital for many things I will show. What's that taste? Well, it's your tongue, a muscular organ in everyone. I'm kind of rough with lots of bumps. I always work hard to get my job done. The muscles in your tongue are a few we will discuss. The stylo-hyo and genio all end in glossus. Then the genio and stylo-hyoideus. Learning these muscles of your tongue, yeah, it is a must. Your tongue's main job's to help you chew and swallow all your food. It also helps you speak all words to express your present mood. The common amount of taste that your tongue can recognize are the four. I will tell you, it may come as a surprise. Sweet, sour, bitter, and salty are the four. But sometimes you taste a fifth called umami I adore. What's that taste? Well, it's your tongue, a muscular organ in everyone. I'm kind of rough with lots of bumps. I always work hard to get my job done. When you bite into your food, the chemicals from foods release and sinks into the taste papilla, to the taste buds that run deep. Sensory cells transform chemicals into nerve signals that are sent into the brain through the nerve fibers they do go. When the signals reach your brain, that information is passed through your cranial nerves to the brainstem really fast. Your medulla oblongata takes all those signals and sends them to the limbic and cortical systems. You should know perception and emotion are then formed from what you ate, then mixed with smells and texture, which create this thing called taste. What's that taste? Well, it's your tongue, a muscular organ in everyone. I'm kind of rough with lots of bumps. I always work hard to get my job done.
Esophagus.
I am your esophagus.
Esophagus.
Attach to the back of your trachea.
Esophagus.
Digestive system's muscular too.
Esophagus.
I bring your food down to the stomach and you. I live in front of your spinal column. I'm right beyond the trachea and heart that pumps. I connect the throat to the stomach in you. Before I reach your stomach, your diaphragm I pass through. My outer muscles are what help me to push through. These muscles contract in wave motions to help me push it through. This wave motion is called peristalsis. Now let's take a look at the muscles that help me do this. The inner to the outer walls of your esophagus are made of four layers of tissue that create peristalsis. The longitudinal sits on my outside, while the circular muscle sits in the middle inside. The inner circular muscle wraps around the esophagus. It contracts by squeezing together just like a closed fist. It squeezes simultaneously with the longitudinal muscle, which runs up and down the esophagus, this long hollow tunnel, lining the hollow center of the esophagus. On the mucosa and submucosa, this is where they sit.
Esophagus.
I am your esophagus.
Esophagus.
Attached to the back of your trachea.
Esophagus.
Digestive system's muscular tube.
Esophagus.
I bring your food down to the stomach and you. When you swallow your food after it is chewed, it passes the epiglottis, which covers the trachea and you. Then the upper esophageal sphincter will stay closed until the brain tells it to open to let your food flow. When food's in your esophagus, peristalsis occurs. That's when circular and longitudinal muscles do work. These two muscles contract in the wave motion shown, pushing your food towards your stomach's main digestive zone. Peristalsis is finished near your stomach stop, where your lower esophageal sphincter lets food drop. Once the food is in your stomach, the lower sphincter closes tight in order to keep the stomach acid out of sight. I'm 8 to 10 inches in tubular length and 3/4 of an inch wide, but I'm full of strength. So take care of me because I am esophagus. Be sure to eat healthy food and drink because it's a must.
Esophagus.
I am your esophagus.
Esophagus.
Attach to the back of your trachea.
Esophagus.
Digestive system's muscular tube.
Esophagus.
I bring your food down to the stomach and you.
Esophagus.
I am your esophagus.
Esophagus.
Attach to the back of your trachea.
Esophagus.
Digestive system's muscular tube.
Esophagus.
I bring your food down to the stomach and you.
Several parts, the right and left. The paddock ducks are where we will start. Here's the common hepatic duct. Then the cystic duct sits where it is tucked. Then we move to the neck, which is attached to the body and the rounded fundus. To the common bile duct. And the pancreatic duct, that is what I'm made of. I am your gallbladder. I am a sac-shaped organ, you see. I am a gallbladder. Your liver stores its bile in me. I act as a reservoir by storing the bile that your liver does for. This bile is made and used to break down fats from all eaten foods. When your food leaves your stomach, it passes through the duodenum. Now that is a fact. That is when I began to work, passing the digestive bile through the common bile duct. When this bile is out of me, I flatten like a deflated balloon, you see. Then the liver, it does the rest. And when you're done digesting food, that's when I ingest all the new bile to store that the body waits to use. That is what I am for. I am your gallbladder. I am a sac-shaped organ, you see. I am a gallbladder. Your liver stores its bile in me. I am your gallbladder. I am a sac-shaped organ, you see. I am a gallbladder. Your liver stores its bile in me.
Small intestine digest all the food that you will eat. I produce all of your bile. Your gallbladder stores it up until food enters your system. Then it secretes your bile ducts. The bile's job to break down fats from all the food you eat, so your small intestine can easily absorb what you will need. I am your liver, the largest organ inside you. I'm like a supercomputer of the body. Another impressive job in which the liver has to do. It filters toxins from your blood and shoots them out with pee and poo. The network of blood vessels within the right and left lobes can store 10% of the body's blood. It filters while it flows. 3 pints of blood is filtered through your liver every minute. So please treat your body well and put the right food and drink in it. I am your liver, the largest organ inside you. I'm like a supercomputer.
I am your pancreas, I'm about 6 inches long. I sit behind your stomach, across the back of your abdomen. The anatomy of your pancreas is the first thing I'll explain. There are 4 main parts to me, and a 5th that it will gain. We'll start with the tail, which sits to the left of your abdomen. abdomen. This is connected to the body onto the neck. It does extend. The neck's attached to the head, which is the fourth main part that you see, which can be split into two parts as I explain the parts of me. When you split up the head proper is what's on top. Then the unseen it processes at the bottom where it drops. There are two main ducts in the pancreas. You see the pancreatic duct and pancreatic duct accessory. I am your pancreas. I'm about 6 inches long. I sit behind your stomach across the back of your abdomen. The two functions of your pancreas that perform day to day are called the endocrine and exocrine to keep you all healthy. Let's talk about the endocrine system in your pancreas. It releases two main hormones from the islets of Langerhans. Insulin and glucagon are the hormones that release. They keep your blood glucose real stable so your cells have energy. Now the exocrine system produces digestive enzymes through the pancreatic duct to the duodenum line. The job of the enzymes is to help digest all your food so it's easily absorbed by the small intestine in you. So take care of your pancreas so it continues to work well, so your food keeps digesting and sends glucose to fuel your cells. I am your pancreas. I'm about 6 inches long. I sit behind your stomach across the back of your abdomen. I am your pancreas. I'm about 6 inches long. I sit behind your stomach across the back of your abdomen. I am your small intestine. Come journey with me. Part of your digestive system in your tummy. Happy. I am a 20-foot long hollow tube. You see, I absorb all of the nutrients that you will need. From your pyloric sphincter, your chime enters me into my duodenum. It's my first part of three. Your duodenum's job is a critical. Your partially digested food ready for absorption. Your liver, pancreas, and your gallbladder secrete the chemicals that mix with your chyme matter, preparing your chyme to be passed to your jejunum. This is where your small intestine starts the absorption. I am your small intestine. Come journey with me. Part of your digestive system in your tummy.
And though I'm shorter than your small, I'm called your large intestine due to my expanded walls. I'm made up of 10 different parts, all connected into one. We'll start at the tip of your appendix, attached to your cecum. The next part of my tubular shape is the ascending colon, which leads to the hepatic flexure, so you're learning in this song. Your transverse colon runs across your entire abdomen, then turns at your splenic flexure onto the descending colon. Your curved S-shaped sigmoid colon leads to your rectum, which is where your fecal matter meets your anus in your bum. I am your large intestine. test. And though I'm shorter than you're small, I'm called your large intestine due to my expanded walls. Let me tell you how I work and a little bit about me. I'm only 5 feet in length, but I'm wide, which is why I'm called Large C. My most important job is absorbing water from your chime. If I didn't perform this function, you'd have loose stools all the time. Millions of bacteria do live inside of me. An important one is E. coli. Its job is very key. E. coli breaks down all the chyme that your body can digest and produces vitamin K that regulates blood clotting at its best. Another important job that your large intestine has to play. Yeah, it excretes all your waste to help your body stay healthy.
I am your large intestine, though I'm shorter than you're small. I'm called your large intestine due to my expanded walls.
Matthew, the Kids Learning Tube creator, made a face reveal video just for you. And the only place to see it is on the new Kids Learning Tube app on Apple and Android devices now. Get unlimited ad-free access to our three